Ben, you are a pundit, especially talking about the cloud, among many other things. Can you tell me a little bit about the diverse topics that you are an expert in?
Sure. So I do a bunch of things, but kind of underlying it is that I'm really excited by the sort of convergence around social, mobile, you know, a new generation of workforce, really flexible and organic workplaces, and that the cloud enables all of that. And really excited, you know, here at Dreamforce this year that we're really seeing a bunch of stuff come together to really, you know, enable a new way of doing business. So it's kind of like it's been 12 or 13 years coming, but finally there's sort of some continuity and we're really delivering upon that promise.
As an angel investor, you are time rich, right? How do you balance your work life and your personal life?
Sure. So, you know, it's kind of hard. I mean, as I said, I'm out here in the US every few weeks, and it's a long way from home, so I do spend a lot of time away from home. But I kind of find some balance in that when I'm at home, you know, I work school hours and, you know, I hang out with my kids a lot, and I kind of leverage technology in order to give me some balance. But it's a big issue, and the difficult thing, the flip side with the cloud and with mobile, is that we can be connected all the time. You know, I've got my phone with me all the time. I'm on Twitter 24/7, and kind of need to actually consciously step back and think about sometimes disconnecting, which is kind of counterintuitive, because the value of the modern world and social media is that we can be connected. But in terms of balance and in terms of kind of, you know, getting some harmony in one's life, you need to kind of disconnect sometimes, and that's really important.
We're at Dreamforce 2012. What's the most visionary company you've seen here?
So I'm really excited to see, you know, we saw at the keynote the other day, we saw General Electric talking about having their jet engines, you know, connected to chatter so they can get some insights and stuff from that. And I think, you know, I've been talking about probably for 5 years the Internet of Things. And the Internet of Things is that every device is going to be connected, you know, to the Internet. And so your refrigerator and your oven and your car, and, you know, it's all going to be connected. And when we see some really, really traditional, you know, 100-year-old companies start talking about connected devices, that's amazing. And that's revolutionary. And so that's really exciting, seeing that go mainstream.